Hello everyone, myself A.S. Falmari, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we will discuss Lagrange's Undetermined Multiplier to find the extreme values of a given function subjected to some condition. The learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to find the stationary values of given function subjected to some conditions. Now, actually, the problem is we have given one function f, which may be a function of two or three independent variable, and with that function we have provided one restriction. Now, in this problem, we want to extremize the given function subjected to certain condition. To find the extreme value in such a problem, we will use Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Now, in the step number one, first we will denote the given function by f. Here we have considered this f as a function of three independent variables. Call it as equation number one. And we will denote the restriction or the subjected condition by the notation phi. Here also we have considered it as a function of x, y, z. And every time we will write in this form, phi of x, y, z equal to 0, and call it as equation number 2. In the step number 2, we have to consider these three equations, which are called as Lagrange's equations. Now call them as equation number 3. Now the step number 3 is, we have to solve these two equations for the values of x, y, z by eliminating lambda. Once we eliminate the lambda and get the values of x, y, z, that values of x, y, z are called the stationary values of this given function 1. And if you substitute these values in this equation 1, we will get the extreme, that is maximum or minimum value of this function subjected to this condition. Now pause this video and find the stationary value of a function x, y subjected to the condition x plus y equal to 16. Whose Lagrange's equation are x plus lambda equal to 0 and y plus lambda equal to 0. I hope that all of you have written the answer. The problem is to finding the stationary values where the Lagrange's equations are provided here. Now the first one is x plus lambda equal to 0. From this equation directly we get the value of x as minus lambda. And second Lagrange's equation is y plus lambda equal to 0, which implies y equal to minus lambda. Now, to eliminate this lambda, we will use this condition x plus y equal to 16. Now, substituting the values of x and y in this equation, we get x as minus lambda, y as also minus lambda equal to 16, which implies minus 2 lambda equal to 16. It implies after dividing by minus 2, lambda equal to minus 8. Now replacing the value of lambda in these two equations, we get the value of x and y as 8 and 8. Now which is the required stationary value of the given function x into y. Let us consider the first example. Find the maximum and minimum values of the function f of x comma y is equal to 3x plus 4y on the circle x square plus y square equal to 1. Using the method of Lagrange's multipliers. Solution. Now in the step number 1, now it is the given function which is to be extremized, therefore we will denote it by small f, call it as equation number 1. This is the restriction. We will write it in a standard form by taking this 1 to the right hand side, and we will denote it by phi as x square plus y square minus 1 is equal to 0. Now call it as equation number 2. Now here the f and the restriction are in terms of two independent variables. Therefore we have two Lagrange's equations. Now that Lagrange's equations are, the first one is dou f by dou x plus lambda times dou phi by dou x equal to 0. It implies, now differentiating this f partially with respect to x, we get it as 3 plus, now differentiating this phi partially with respect to x, we get it as 2x, but already lambda is there, therefore it is 2x lambda and equal to 0. Now let us call it as equation number 3. Now one more Lagrange's equation we have, dou f by dou y plus lambda times dou phi by dou y equal to 0, which implies, now differentiating this f partially with respect to y, treating remaining variables constant, we get the value as 4 plus lambda times, now differentiating phi partially with respect to y, its derivative is 0 and y square has the derivative 2y, and this lambda as it is, and minus 1 has the derivative 0, that therefore it is equal to 0. Now let us call it as equation number 4. Now in the next step, our aim is to eliminate lambda from this 2, 3 and 4 and get the values of x, y, z, which are our required stationary values. Now to do so, from 3 we can see that it is possible to obtain the value of x, and which is minus 3 by 2 lambda, call it as equation number 5. Now from this 4, it is possible to find the value of y as minus 2 by lambda, call it as equation number 6. In order to eliminate this lambda, we will use this condition number 2. We will substitute the value of x and y here. Now putting the value of x and y in 2, we get it is x square, and the value of x is minus 3 by 2 lambda square plus next term is y square, and y is minus 2 by lambda bracket square and minus 1 as it is equal to 0. Now the square of this term is 9 upon 4 lambda square plus, and its square is 4 upon lambda square minus 1 is equal to 0. We can make the same denominator here by multiplying a denominator by 4 to the second term. We get here 4 into 4, 16. And here it is 4 lambda square. Now 16 plus 9 is 25 upon 4 lambda square minus 1 is equal to 0. Now it implies 25 upon 4 lambda square is equal to 1 after taking 1 to the right hand side. Now taking lambda square to the right hand side, we get lambda square equal to 25 upon 4. But we want the value of lambda. It implies lambda equal to 5 by 2 comma minus 5 by 2. Thus we have obtained two values of lambda, one is 5 by 2, another is minus 5 by 2. We will substitute the values of lambda in 5 and 6 to get the stationary values. As we have obtained two values, we will consider them in two different cases. Now the case number 1, consider the first value of lambda as 5 by 2. Now from 5, replacing lambda by 5 by 2, we get x equal to minus 3 by 2 into lambda, lambda is 5 by 2. Which is equal to, we can remove this 2, we get the value as minus 3 by 5. Now from 6, putting the value of lambda, y equal to minus 2 by, it is lambda, lambda is 5 by 2, which is equal to, this 2 is in the denominator of denominator, we can write it in numerator, so it is minus 4 by, the first pair of xy, which is we have obtained as minus 3 by 5 and minus 4 by 5. Now this is the stationary value. To find the extreme value, let us substitute the stationary value in the given function 1. Therefore, at the stationary point minus 3 by 5 comma minus 4 by 5, the function f has the value 3 into x is minus 3 by 5 plus 4 into y is minus 4 by 5, which is equal to 3 into minus 3 is minus 9 by 5, and it is 4 into minus 4 is minus 16 by 5. That is equal to denominator is same. We can add the numerators. So minus 16 minus 9 minus 25 by 5, which is equal to minus 5. So this is one extreme value of the given function which is obtained at this stationary point. We have one more value of lambda. We will consider it in case number 2. Consider lambda equal to minus 5 by 2. Again, from 5, we get the value of x equal to minus 3 by 2 into minus 5 by 2, 2 will be removed and minus minus plus 3 by 5. From 6, replacing the value of lambda as minus 5 by 2, we get y equal to minus of 2 upon in bracket minus 5 by 2, minus minus will be plus, now this 2 will be in the numerator, so it is plus 4 by 5. Now this is 3 by 5 and 4 by 5 is the next stationary value. Let us calculate the value of the function at this stationary point, that is at 3 by 5 comma 4 by 5. F is 3x plus 4y. Substituting the values, we get 3 into 3 by 5 plus 4 into 4 by 5, which is equal to 9 by 5 plus 16 by 5. As the denominators are same, adding the numerators, we get 16 plus 9 is 25 by 5, which is equal to 5. Thus, we have obtained two extreme values of given function. One is minus 5 and another one is plus 5. So, obviously, we can say that the minimum value of the given function f subjected to the given condition is minus 5 and the maximum value is 5.